to have e-riksha, e-cart, e-dhobi, and e-garibs also. Sir, what I understand from this bill is it wants to regularize e-rikshas and e-carts in the national capital. We understand the urgency of the government with the elections around the corner. It is obviously understandable. There is no problem. They did it. Why won't you do it? Nobody cares for the country. It is a question of vying for each other's throat. And since they did it, it justifies that you do it. What I have heard is that these rickshaws are described as special purpose battery powered vehicles. And we are limiting the number of passengers to only 4 persons and the weight of baggage to 40 kilos. As if the police constable, who till yesterday could not even challan them, the Honorable Minister has said, it is on record, that the police, the traffic police of Delhi, cannot challan these vehicles. So on one hand, you are putting restrictions. On the other hand, you are telling, you are informing the law enforcement agencies that you cannot take action against them. And we know all across India that when vehicles are meant to carry 6 people, they carry 60 people. And sir, you come from an illustrious state where we only see pictures of people bulging out of all kinds of vehicles. Sir, what worries me is that the name of a great statesman, a lover of India, a true Hindu, Deen Dayal Upadhyay, has been used in this project by the Honorable Minister. We have great respect for the Honorable Minister. He is the person who has paved the way for a group of corrupt people to be thrown out and a new group to have come in. So he has done a commendable job for this country. We are all praised for him. He has led the party to success. But at the same time, I must say that there are doubts whether the name of a great, late lamented person like Deen Dayal ji should have been used in this kind of a thing. The little bit that I have read about him, he was a very strict man who always obeyed the social laws and who was always very disciplined. So giving a name connected with that kind of a personality only shows that there is not much concern for his ideals in today's new setup, which is unwilling to accept that the roads of Delhi are very choked. Sir, if you would have gone recently to Ashoka Road, you would have noticed that the road, which is a main thoroughfare of the city, has been blocked from both sides. Woe begone those people who have homes there and cannot reach their own homes. They have to go and live with other people. Some of them came to me. I live next door on Firoz Shah Road, number 2, by the way. And they came knocking to my door, at my door, wanting to know if they could spend the night there. And I was a little shaky about that. Sir, the whole world is now thinking of modern means of transport. With your fossil fuels going down, fossil fuels becoming more expensive, and everybody knowing that India's import bill, 50% of India's import bill is petroleum products, it is definitely commendable that we think of alternative means of transport. I have per se no opposition to e-rickshaws or e-carts. It is welcome to have such things. But I would have preferred if the Honorable Minister would have considered that along with e-rickshaws and e-carts, just because the court said due to some 137 accidents involving e-rickshaws till June of this year, and an infant's death occurring because of one of these accidents, The courts had banned it, so this law has been brought in to subvert the court's judgment. But that is also acceptable because in today's India, everything is acceptable. I am not cribbing on that. All I am saying is, would the government and the Honorable Minister think about, consider about other kinds of vehicles like hybrid cars? Sir, one or two companies had brought in hybrid cars to India. One of them I remember was Toyota, I think. But the taxes were so high that finally those cars did not sell. All over the world today, hybrid cars have a separate lane. If you are driving a non-hybrid car, you cannot go on that lane also. You are challenged. So hybrid cars and electric cars have separate lanes, separate facilities. It would be wise on the part of the government if they consciously, starting from these e-carts and e-rickshaws, and not only telling us that lakhs of families depend for their roji roti on making a mess of the already badly congested Indian roads, they actually start thinking about getting better kinds of vehicles which have low emission, less pollution, less usage of fuel, and more environment friendly. And I would request the Honorable Minister that he should rethink about this, especially Delhi is now one of the most polluted cities in the world. So Delhi needs his kind, benevolent look, and I hope he will be willing to rethink. And as this motley crowd said, that send it to a, I'm escaping because they're not there, that send it to a standing committee. I would request that he may consider this as a positive note and rethinks on it. Thank you, without any support. Thank you, sir.
Sri Ram Mohan Naidu.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak on this Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill.